Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Florence Kopleff Recital Hall here at the Georgia State University School of Music. Please take a moment to silence all electronic devices. We would like to remind you that there is no food, drink, or flash photography allowed in the recital hall. Thank you for visiting Georgia State University School of Music, and please enjoy the performance.
Here we go. Muchas gracias. Thank you very much. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. We are M5 Mexican Brass, and this is our second concert in Atlanta and the first time we perform in Georgia. I can't say that about myself, but about the group. Welcome, everybody. Welcome, President Brian M. Blake, president of GSU. Somewhere here. Welcome, the Dean of the College of the Arts, Wade West. Welcome the director of the School of Music, Dr. Chester Phillips. Welcome. The VIC Charter School and the Meadow Creek High School. And welcome everybody from Georgia State University School of Music and all the other guests. This was Vuelta de Fuego. Vuelta de Fuego you could translate as Ride of Fire or also Return with Fire. This is the translation we prefer right now after the two COVID years. You know, performing arts was quite silent. And we are right now currently on our first US tour after COVID. So there were 16 years before and now second chapter. And it's very, I'm very glad being a professor here that I could bring this group and we can perform Brassination for you. And the next piece is homage to one of the most beautiful festivities in the world, Dia de los Muertos, the Day of the Death, a Mexican tradition which just happened on November 1st, and we're going to play Lela Fantasy just for you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Lela by Rosendo Mato. One question. President Blake, do you want to address some words to the students? I can't really see you. I know you're there. Over there? No? So, the next piece is an homage to a big tradition in Mexico, but not only in Mexico, also in the United States and in large parts of Europe. Symphonic wind ensembles are always part of a very folkloric tradition, and they play the overtures up and down. Who also plays the overtures up and down is Bugs Bunny. Whenever you watch Bugs Bunny, you listen to the good music. There's Mozart, there's Rossini, and there's Wagner. And we became fans of Bugs Bunny on long intercontinental flights. And we're going to play for you the entire overture of Il Barbiere di Sevilla by Giacchino Rossini, who wrote the first soundtrack to Bugs Bunny.
Thank you.
Molte grazie. Cavatura Il Barbier di Seville, Giacchino Rossini. And as we are once at the opera, I think we have a bunch of singers here today. Singers? Who? There's one. Wonderful. So from the Italian opera to the German opera, it seems a small step, but there are ages in between, stylistically and also philosophically. So the German Romantic opera started way before Richard Wagner, and had it's culminating in Richard Wagner. But if you want an introduction to Richard Wagner's work, Hänsel and Gretel by Engelbert Humperdinck is a wonderful introduction and first piece. Humperdinck was a student of Richard Wagner, and the opera was kind of an accident from Christmas songs for his niece, and the family loved them so much that he filled the space in between, and the most beautiful fairy tale opera came out, Hänsel and Gretel. And this will lead into Wagner. Afterwards, we're gonna play a piece with some students and faculty from GSU, so get ready. But here comes our favorite piece from Hänsel and Gretel, the evening prayer, der Abendsegen. Once upon the time in a German forest, four Mexicans and the rest you think yourself. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please, a strong applause for the brass students of the GSU brass area and Dr. Bill Mann, the trombone professor of GSU. As I mentioned, as I mentioned, Engelbert Humperdinck is literally the perfect introduction to music of Richard Wagner. And we want to play one little bit from Wagner's opera, Der Tannhäuser, which we actually, I have to tell the story why they set up. The opera Tannhäuser is set on a castle in Germany that actually exists and is about a competition, a singer's contest that happened in the 10th century, quite a while ago. This castle is still there, and while we were on Europe tour in May, we went by, I wanted to show them the castle, and on that night, there was a performance of the opera Der Tannhäuser in the hall, which is in the opera. Quite extraordinary. And the opera, the orchestra that performed that concert was an opera that Richard Wagner conducted himself. Not that night, but hundreds of years earlier. So here comes Der Einzug der Gäste, the entrance of the guests and the knights, Der Tannhäuser by Richard Wagner. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Richard Wagner and the students of GSU would have thought that we get those two together. And the next piece is going back in time. It's a little bit difficult to announce the piece. Johann Sebastian Bach is always most likely the favorite composer of brass players simply because it's one root of our repertoire. Problem is the next piece is not by Bach. It's by Antonio Vivaldi, but Bach liked the piece. It's a violin concerto that Bach liked and arranged for harpsichord, and we liked the arrangement and arranged it for brass. So here we play Antonio Vivaldi violin concerto by Bach and Vivaldi and M5. I hope you enjoy. Thank you. And as we're already back to German medieval music, we found a piece which you can find in the composition of almost all the great composers. So we want to squeeze all of musical history into the next 11 minutes, which will save you thousands of dollars and many nights of opera and concert. No, don't save them. Never ever save this. But so there's a German folk song, it's called Der alte Peter, the old Peter, and somehow all the composers stole a little bit, and you can find it in their repertoire. We're gonna go through, and maybe you'll recognize the composers, but before we're gonna play the song for you, as it is in its original. Der alte Peter sounds like this. Thank you. Yeah, Alte Peter, and if you did not recognize these composers, you need to repeat your classes. And if your favorite composer was not there, well, that's tough. The next piece caused a little bit of discussion backstage. Some of us wanted to play a blues, and others wanted to play a piece by Chopin. So now we're going to play a blues by Chopin. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros en el trombón, on the trombone, Roberto Carlos Chani Cruz. Charlie is the youngest of all of us. You can't really see this, but anybody of us could be his father. Right. So beside Charlie, we have Jose, who is a representation of Mexico's history. His father was a tuba player, his grandfather was a tuba player, his great-great-grandfather was a tuba player. And it goes on until Netzahualcoyotl, who was a king. If you look at his nose, this profile is on the 100 peso bill. So we suspect that Jose is responsible for corruption in Mexico when... Whenever the police stops him, he gives a 100 peso bill and they think it's his driver's license. Jose Lopez on the tuba. And when he was 7 years old, only 7 years old, his parents bought him a French horn, put him in a youth orchestra with 3,000 kids and only 90 French horns. I think that's in tune again. And he started selling horns, buying horns, getting horn magazines, having horn friends, horn girlfriends. Later, he talks about horns and repairs horns and became a really great horn player, Juan Carlos Quiterio. And he is the only one of the five of us who is from Mexico City, so watch your wallet. And Oscar comes from up in the mountains, a little village.
Ugly.
Yeah, ugly little village. 50% of the inhabitants of this village are musicians. What do the other 50% do?
Sell the beer.
they sell the beer. Right. Oscar Villegas on the trumpet. Hello.
Good morning. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the pleasure to introduce you. Let me tell you something about him. He is a good friend. In tours like this, is our chef, our yoga teacher. As you can see, it's our designer. And sometimes he wants to play with us. Ladies and gentlemen, from Berlin, Germany, Alexander El Güerito of the Balkans Front.
That was a surprise. This morning I didn't speak a word English. Google Translator. We're M5 Mexican Brass, and the next piece we want to play for you is our favorite song by the Beatles, Michelle. Thank you. Thank you very much. And the next piece we play is from Mexico. You like Mexican music? You like Mexican food? So here come our three favorite Mexican songs, La Llorona, La Sandunga, y La Malagueña, and together it's La Yosandeña. Muchas gracias. The next piece we want to play is the last piece because the class is over. but it is, after this piece, if you want, everybody can get a Mexican hug. If you didn't know, Mexicans hug on the other side. Heart to heart looks like this. Thank you.
Thank you. Cuando me crece mi tierra, la quiero.